To say you've done enough. This is the time to really do your stuff. And even if you can't be a soldier in the ranks, you can be the guy to help supply the guns and planes and tanks. This is the time for you to do your best. This is no time for you to take a rest. The enemy is reeling and his morale is low. Now's the time to fall in line and deal the final blow. Bye, 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 buy a bond. And by, the bonds you buy will bring you victory. Bye, 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 buy a bond. And you'll be standing by the victory arch when Johnny comes marching home again. Oh, you should need no request. For after all, you know that you're investing in the best. Till the lads come back again, back the old attack again, and bye, bye, bye.
The King's men saying this little bond went to battle.
Once upon a time, there was a nursery rhyme that gave the kids a chuckle and a smile. Now the words are changed, it's all been rearranged to serve a purpose even more worthwhile. This little bond went to battle. This little bond fought at home. This little bond turned the lights on again on top of the Capitol dome. This little bond sent torpedoes into a U-boat pen. Every bond has slammed to the foes of Uncle Sam. So let's keep on slamming them again. Everybody knows just how the saying goes. The pen is even mightier than the sword. So get out your pen and write those checks again. Then Uncle Sam can pass along the word. This little bond went to battle. This little bond fought at home. This little bond bought B-29 guns and mercurial chrome. On a lifeboat that crossed a stormy foam. Baby bombs for peace, may your worthy to bring the boys back home.
History, in every century, records an act that lives forevermore. We'll recall, as into line we fall, the thing that happened on Hawaii shore. Let's remember Pearl Harbor as we go to meet the foe. Let's remember Pearl Harbor as we did the Alamo. We will always remember how they died for liberty. Let's remember Pearl Harbor and go on to victory.
Johnny's in the Army, Tommy's in the Navy, Father's buying saving bonds and stamps. Mother's knitting sweaters, Sister's writing letters, and sending cigarettes to all the camps. In every city, town, and tank, and on the lips of every Yank, the word is fight, unite, and fight. 130 million standing ready day and night. For the flag, for the home, for the family. For the parchment that Hancock signed. For the end of the enemy. Mr. Yankee Doodle's absolutely made up his mind.
Tell the world
that the feather's in his hat.
Tell the world
that the Yankees are at bat.
For the flag, for the home, for the family, for the future of all mankind.
Thank you.
century records an act that lives forevermore. We'll recall, as into line we fall, the thing that happened on Hawaii shore. Let's remember Pearl Harbor as we go to meet the foe. Let's remember Pearl Harbor as we did the Alamo. We will always remember how they died for liberty. Let's remember Pearl Harbor and go on to victory.
Surprise.
How do you do, my dear? And Mr. McGee?
Hi, Effie. That's quite a fur jacket you got there. You look like a perpendicular fox farm. Hey, what's the matter with you, Effie? If you looked any more upset, you'd have to walk on your hands.
Oh, I am perturbed, Mr. McGee. Oh. I'm having a group of naval officers to dinner tonight.
Oh, well, they're used to having dinner in a mess. What's wrong, Abigail?
Oh, everything, my dear. I can't buy any meat.
Oh, my.
My butcher is entirely out. He says the black market is taking so much meat that the legitimate dealers have a hard time getting their quota.
Well, be that as it may be or may not be or not, Effie, it's all in knowing the right people. I can arrange for you to get some meat.
What do you know about meat, McGee? You always thought Chuck Beep was off a steer named Charlie.
I just know my way around, that's all. If anybody wants meat, I know where they can get it. Now, look, Uppy, you're an old pal of mine.
Let's say acquaintance, Miss McGee. My regard for you falls somewhat short of complete adoration.
It does? Mm. Well, that's darn decent of you, Uppy. I always spoke well of you, too. Now, look, you know where the pool hall is on 14th Street, next door to the Friend in Need pawn shop?
Why, certainly I know where the... I believe I could locate it.
Well, all you gotta do is go down there, duck up the alley...
Are you suggesting that Abigail duck up an alley, McGee?
Well, how does she usually go up alleys? On a calliope? Just sneak up the alley, Uppy, when nobody is watching, and there's a door at the end, see? You just whistle twice like a snipe, and a guy named Eddie will open the door. You tell him that...
Mr. McGee, this sounds suspiciously like the black market to me.
Don't be silly. This ain't a market at all. It's just a back room off the pool hall. And it ain't black. It's a kind of a bilious green. Used to be a bookmaker in there, and he
McGee,
was...
McGee, how do you know all about this?
How do I know anything?
I have often wondered.
Oh, I just go around with my ears and eyes to the ground, that's all. Now, look, Uppy, when you see this guy, Eddie, he whistles like a snipe, you see? You tell him you know me. You don't need any coupons.
McGee... I don't like this.
Well, gee whiz, if you really want meat bad enough, you gotta do
I don't want meat badly enough to patronize a back alley dealer, Mr. McGee. Do you think I could face those servicemen tonight after dealing in the black market?
Well, my gosh, Uppy, you said
you didn't... Do you think that I would have the unmitigated effrontery to invite servicemen to dinner and serve them meat which was practically stolen from law-abiding citizens?
Well, gee whiz,
to
yes.
offer them something which was damaging the legitimate business of the country they're fighting for?
Well, gee whiz.
If you do, Mr. McGee, you know as much about me as a hyena knows about international law.
What's wrong with Uncle Sam? He's cut out on my sugar. Now he's messing with my ham. I got the ration blue. Blue as I can be. For me. I've got those ration blue. I gotta live on 40 ounces. Of any kind of meat. Those 40 little ounces gotta last me all the week. I gotta cut out on my jelly. It takes sugar to make it sweet. I'm gonna steal all your jelly, baby, and rob you of your meat. I got the ration blues. Blue as I. I've got those ration blues. I like to wake up in the morning with my jelly by my side. Since rationing started, baby, you just take your stuff and hide. They reduced my meat and sugar and rubber's disappearing fast. You can't ride no more with Papa, 'cause Uncle Sam wants my gas. I got the ration blues. I can be for me. I've got those ration blues.
There were three little sisters. Three little sisters, each one only in her feet. One loved a soldier, one loved a sailor, one loved a lad from the Marine. All the three little sisters, they were the fairies from Iceland to the Philippines. So said the soldier, said the sailor, so said the lad from the Marine. And when the boys marched away, the girls said they'd be true until the boys came back someday. Now, three little sisters, stay home and read their magazine. Tell it to the soldiers. Tell it to the sailor, tell it to the Marine. little sisters off their home and read their magazine. Tell it to the soldiers. Tell it to the sailors. And tell it to the
This is the G.I. Jive, man alive. It starts with the bugler blowing reveille over your bed when you arrive. Jack, that's the G.I. Jive. Rootledy-toot, jump in your suit, make a salute. After you wash and dress, more or less, you go get your breakfast in a beautiful little cafe they call the Mess. Jack, when you convalesce, out of your seat, into the street, make with the feet. If you're a PVT, your duty is to salute the L-I-E-U-T. But if you brush the L-I-E-U-T, the M-P makes you K-P on the Q-T. This is the G.I. Jive, man alive. They give you a private tank that features a little device called fluid drive. Jack, after you revive, chunk all your junk back in the trunk, fall on your bunk, clunk. Jive, man alive. They give you a private tank that features a little device called a fluid drive. Jack, if you still survive, chunk all your junk back in the trunk, fall on your bunk.
Like most conscientious citizens, I wish to get the utmost mileage out of the gasoline allowed me while not exceeding 35 miles an hour.
Yes?
So I wondered if it would help to maintain the lower speed if I drove with the emergency brake on.
Oh. Oh, my gosh, don't do that. Why, you'll wear out your brakes in no time, Uppy. Oh. And besides, your engine will keep stopping.
Oh, yes, 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 I noticed that, Mr. McGee. It stopped again as I drove up in front of your house just now.
That's what you did, Abigail. You killed your engine.
Good heavens. And it was such a good engine, too. Oh, well, I shall have my butler give it a decent burial in the backyard tonight. Perhaps a few flowers.
No. You don't have to bury it, Uppy. It'll come to life again. And I'm glad you mentioned that mileage rationing. You know what they done to me, Uppy?
Oh, dear. Here comes the moan of the mistreated motorist again.
They only gave me a book, Uppy. 4 gallons a week. It's an infringement on personal liberty. That's what it's an infringement on.
Taking McGee as an average citizen, Abigail, I bet you never realized how low the average was, did you?
No.
Well, Mr. McGee, as usual, you are being stupidly self-centered. Any intelligent person knows that every extra unnecessary mile of wear on a single tire is practically sabotage. Do you think for one single minute that your drab little driving habits are of any importance whatsoever during times like these?
Well, Dad Raddatz, I don't think...
That is obvious, Mr. McGee. Goodbye.
Oh, so you're one of the moaners and groaners. One of those astigmatic individuals who thinks the war is being fought only by soldiers and sailors and marines.
Well,
let me tell you it isn't. Everything you do in your daily life has some effect on our war program.
Oh, yeah, I suppose the way I comb my hair is important, too, huh?
Yes, it is. What's your comb made of? Rubber.
Oh.
That's a piece of rubber that didn't go into a tire. It was made when this country had plenty of rubber, and we haven't got plenty now. We're dangerously short of it. What we have got, we need for military purposes and essential transportation. Do you belong to a car pool?
Well, no.
Are you engaged in any important war work, McGee?
Well, no, I guess not, but gee whiz...
Then for heaven's sake, stop your griping. You're lucky you've got a car at all. Oh, excuse me, McGee. When I get over to Africa or Australia or wherever they send me, I'll be thinking of you, McGee, and the hardships you're suffering. Well, goodbye, Mrs. McGee. I'll see you when this is over.
Goodbye, Mr. Mayor, and happy landing.
Thank you. Goodbye, McGee.
Good luck, Latrivia. Don't take any wooden anchors.
I won't. And, McGee,
huh?
When you do drive, if you get up to 35 miles an hour, think of somebody who didn't get a rubber lifeboat. Goodbye.
Today's the day that all us cats must surely do our bit. We all must do our share so Uncle Sam can hit. Save up all your pots and pans. Save up every little thing you can. Don't give it away. Get some cash for your trash can. Save up all that old newspaper. Save and pile it like a high skyscraper. Don't give it away. Get some cash for your trash.
You know, this is a very interesting government folder Abigail gave us, McGee.
Yeah?
Listen, it says, in our attics, cellars, backyards, and basements are waste materials that can help make ships, tanks, guns, and ammunition.
Hmm.
Salvage now for victory. Well, come on, McGee, let's get busy.
Okay.
I'll be glad to get that closet cleaned out.
Yeah, me too. Oh, okay, open her up.
No, you open it.
No, you open her. I opened it the last time.
Yeah, but you can jump out of the way quicker than I can.
Well, okay, here goes.
Well.
There, see? No cause to be alarmed because... Just look at that, will you? Well, there ought to be plenty of stuff in here for the government, Molly.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Oh, there's an old aluminum coffee pot. We can give that to the government.
Oh, but that's what I use to make my camping trips.
Well, tap a tree and drink maple syrup. This goes to Uncle Sam. Aluminum is a very important thing.
Yeah. Let's see. Better make 3 piles of this stuff we're saving for the government. Rubber in one, metal in another, and paper in... Hey, look.
What?
There's my old ukulele.
What's the matter, Mr. McGee? You seem kind of nervous.
Keep away from the window, Alice. There's a German spy across the street. That guy's smart.
McGee thinks he's a spy because you wouldn't loan him his lawnmower, Alice.
Oh, but I've met Mr. Smalls, and I think he's very nice, Mr. McGee. I see him all the time out near the airplane plant.
Out near the airplane plant, eh? You hear that, Molly?
Well, I've walked out near the airplane plant lots of times myself without getting any nasty notes from J. Edgar Hoover.
Oh, well, I'm sure he doesn't mean any harm, Mr. McGee. All he does is walk around and take pictures.
Take pictures? Oh, is that all? Just goes out to the airplane plant to take pictures? My gosh, girls, don't that mean anything to you?
Well, it does to me. It means that all the time he's out there, you haven't once broken into his garage to borrow the lawnmower.
Well, besides, Mr. McGee, he doesn't take pictures of the airplane plant.
Huh? He doesn't?
No. He just takes pictures of us girls when we're out on the lawn during the noon hour.
You see, McGee, he's merely a middle-aged masher with a negative personality.
You sure he don't take any pictures of the plant, Alice?
Oh, never, Mr. McGee. And I don't even see how his pictures of us girls ever come out good with all those airplanes parked in the background. Gee, you'd think he'd...
What, airplanes? He lines you kids up to take pictures just for an excuse to get airplanes in the pictures. Can't you see that? What kind of cameras he got?
Well, creepers, Mr. McGee, I don't remember, but I think it's a little Leica.
A little Leica what? Come, come, girl. This is important. A little like a what?
Well, it's just a little like a...
women. My gosh, can't get any sense out of them. I'm telling you, this guy's a dangerous character that ought...
Lie down on the floor, quick.
He caught on to me. He shook it out. Hey, lie down, Molly. Lie down.
Don't be silly.
Huh?
That was a milk truck backfiring.
Oh.
But what broke the window?
McGee stuck his hand through it when the truck backfired. Are you cut, dearie?
No. Just tore my coat sleeve a little. Well, that just goes to show you, you gotta be Jerry at the rat hole in a case like this. Mind my words, Alice. Keep an eye on that small guy.
Oh, I will, Mr. McGee.
Don't talk too much. Don't know too much, Jack. Don't be too hip, cause a slip of the lip might sink a ship. Don't see too much, boy. Don't jive too much, Jack. Don't be so hip, cause a slip of the lip might sink a ship. The walls have ears, the night has eyes. So let's be wise and trick those nasty, nasty spies. Shh, don't talk too much. Shh, don't know too much, boy. Don't be too hip, cause flip of the lip might sink a ship. Just to be loquacious. I'd sink a ship.
Oh, excuse me, sis. I thought you were the mailman.
I am the mailman. Heavenly days. A lady mailman.
Gee.
Say, I hope Mr. Underwood isn't ill.
No, madam. Mr. Underwood is now in the army. I will bring your mail for the duration.
Well, what do you know? One of these days, this country's going to have just two classes of people, soldiers and women.
Mary Brown, she wore that uniform like a $1 million gown. How my heart would leap when she drove a Jeep with the one big stripe on her arm. And it seemed to me that a PFC stood for perfect feminine charm. First class private Mary Brown. Oh, how she smiled goodbye when they shipped me out of town. Let the big guns roar, let me win this war, cause I want to hurry right back to first class, Private Mary Brown, my wonderful wife.
First class, Private Mary Brown, I've got her army serial number written down. She was all GI, but when she marched by, I just had to look at her twice. And it struck me then that the ASM meant an angel specially nice.
First class, Private Mary Brown, could make the PX seem like the Ritz in New York town. Let the big guns roar, let me win this war, cause I want to hurry right back on the double to first class, Private Mary Brown, my wonderful back.
Let the big guns roar, let us win this war,
cause I want to hurry right back on the double to first class, Private Mary,
Mary
Brown, my wonderful wag.
Uncle Sam wants workers with special skills. If you are a tack welder, flanging press operator, plate hanger, mixer operator of explosives, or outside machinist, or are skilled in any similar work, please report to your nearest United States Employment Service office now.
Well, what on earth is a tack welder? Personally, if I break a tack, I just throw it away.
Probably nobody knows what a tack welder is but another tack welder. Fact remains that the government needs them in war production. You hear anything about this on the radio?
On the swing ship all night, turning out my quota. All right, now I'm beat right down to the side. Gotta catch myself some righteous nod. So milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Milkman, stop that grade A riot. Cut out if you can't lullaby it. Oh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Been knocking out a fat tank all day, working on a bomber. Okay, boy, you blast my wig with those planks, and I got to catch my 40 wings. So, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. I don't mind it, cause the man with the whiskers has a lot behind it, but I can't keep punching with the victory crew when you're making me punch you with that bottle blue. I wanna give my all if I'm gonna give it, but I gotta get my shut eye if I'm gonna rip it. So fill up butt with that milk barrage, cause it's unpatriotic, it's a sabotage. Working on a bomber. Okay, boy, you blast my wig with a clink, and I got to catch my 40 winks. So, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Ooh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet. Ooh, milkman, keep those bottles quiet.
Quiet!
Thank you.
decks for action. The time for speech is past. And do the job we have to do and get it over fast. Let's put the axe to the axis. Let them know that their show is all through. Oh, let's put the axe to the axis. Lend a hand to the land we love true. With all our might, we'll fight, because we know we're right. And then, again, the future will be bright. So let's put the axe to the axis and finish up the trouble they began. Try a can to Japan and the rest. Oh, let's get real nasty to Nazis. Italy will soon see that we're best. There is no doubt about the fact we'll never stop until we will, like always, land on top. So let's put the axe to the axis and teach them not to pick on Uncle Sam.